Hi, I'm Spriha, co-founder of Aviator.co. We're an engineering productivity platform, and we build bots to help developers automate mundane tasks on their Git repositories. When you have a massive monorepo, everyone on the team is making changes to the same code base. So how do you merge code coming in from a large number of developers into that single monorepo while also ensuring that the combined product always produces a version that works? In other words, how do you ensure that your main branch doesn't break? At Aviator, these are the kinds of problems that we like to solve, engineering productivity related problems. We work with many types of companies, all the way from large, well-known Fortune 100 companies to fast-growing startups to solve their developer workflow and productivity problems, especially as they scale. This quick talk will focus on one specific problem, which is how do you maintain a working monorepo at scale so that your developers don't have to worry about babysitting their pull requests through all sorts of cumbersome code merge processes every time they want to merge code. So one way you could enforce an always working sort of main branch on the monorepo is just through a manual process. So you can say that all developers, before they submit code, should update to the latest version of the main branch just before they actually commit their code in to ensure that it doesn't break, it all works great and it doesn't break the main branch. So while this works initially, you'll realize that you soon get to a point where by the time you've updated to the latest branch and checked that your code still works, somebody else has unfortunately just snuck in their code, and now you'll have to update all over again and hope that nobody else merges their code in before you're done this time. So to automate this, you realize this becomes really, you know, cumbersome, and so you want to start automating this. And so to automate this manual process, you may decide that, hey, I want to build a bot. And we at Aviator actually did build a bot, where you now have a bot that maintains a queue of pull requests in a very sort of simple first in, first out fashion. This bot then updates each pull request with the latest changes to check that it doesn't break the main branch, merges it, updates the next PR, and so on. If any of these fail or causes a build breakage, it doesn't actually merge that PR, just moves on to the next one. Well, this also works up to a certain point, but then you realize that you eventually hit a stage where there are just so many PRs in the queue that there aren't enough hours in the day to process each one, one by one especially. So at this point, you decide, you know what, you're going to batch things. Instead of testing PRs one at a time, you can test, say, 4 or 5 PRs in a batch, and that way things move a lot faster. Of course, if the batch works with no conflicts, you can merge every PR within the batch. But if the batch doesn't work, you can run some sort of bisection algorithm to figure out which specific PR in the batch caused the main branch to break. But then you discover that when everything's compatible and this batching system actually works great, but when a batch fails, it takes a very long time to isolate the offending PRs. And this time becomes increasingly long as your batch size increases. So one thing you could then do is parallelize these PRs. Instead of waiting for a batch of, say, 4 or 5 to fill up before starting tests, you can kickstart testing on various subsets of PRs as the batch fills up. This way, whichever subset works, you can merge that in. And it's way easier to triangulate a failing PR just by looking at the difference between batches that contain the PR and batches that don't contain the PR. This also, you realize, works a lot better. Things are a lot faster now. But you realize that, hey, your finance department is not too happy with you because your CI costs have just shot through the roof. So the final thing you could do is selectively parallelize depending on what's actually changed within these PRs. That way, if you've got a PR that only changes, say, a README file, you can merge that PR independently from a PR that adds a new feature in, for example, in entirely separate queues. In other words, you maintain multiple queues when you know that the PRs within those multiple queues are completely independent of each other. And when PRs are dependent on each other, you fall back to the regular queuing mechanism and you test them together. In fact, if you use a build system like Bazel, it can give you that information that lets you very easily determine which PRs are independent and which PRs are dependent on each other. Of course, you could take this to a whole other level. You could take all sorts of other signals into account while grouping these PRs into multiple queues. You know, things like who wrote the PR? How often does this part of the code base get updated? Stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, there you have it. These are some strategies that should be a good start and will hopefully take you a long way as you scale your monorepo. At Aviator, we've built tooling to support all of this, and these strategies have been battle-hardened over many production-grade monorepos at various sizes of various different customers and various sizes of organizations. So if you want to discuss this stuff or just even just generally chat about engineering productivity issues, I'm more than happy to discuss this stuff with you. Send me an email. I'm at spriha@aviator.co. And in fact, because we see so many different organizations solving these similar challenges, I can even tell you how others like your teams have solved the problems that you're looking to solve. Well, thank you so much, and may your monorepo scale well with you.